For the second round between Claremont and Blunt Force Trauma, Blunt Force has a lot to do. They need to get 10 captures to tie, and that's actually going to be quite difficult against this defense. We have Bio Soldier, arguably his best class. We have Alex Engineer, his definite best class on defense. Bostwick's Heavy, that's what he plays for his team. And Nine Demo, it's... Nine's a very all-around player, but he definitely does shine as Demo. And we have Cherry, Moya, and Gooster as Medic, leaving Moto as Scout. I'd argue this is their best route to go for an offense. I think they need all the killing power they can get in this matchup. And Bio really holding down this button already with 3 kills, and now it's open. This Medic should just get the security. Nice try by Alex to stop. He does get the nade off and kills too. Overall, nice teamwork by this defense. But the problem is that the sentry gun is level 2. It does actually stay up. Cherry should have gotten that sentry. That would have been a huge deal. And once again, the sentry gun just won't die. That's actually one of the perks for the sentry gun being on those steps. It's a very awkward position for the nades to go around, as they can get stuck at the bottom of the steps and do minimal damage to that sentry gun. One of the best spots, I'd say, for that sentry gun, and I love seeing it being put there. Now, security has gone down. We have a Medic coming into Flagrim. Demo and Heavy are down. The flag is grabbed by the Scout and almost tossed out. Nice job by Moya and Moto. Now, it is taking Blunt Force Trauma a little bit to get this flag out. They got our flag! Moving this flag, and I'd argue it's just as important to get at least the touches on the flag. But as security is up, this flag is right against the door, and it's a very easy spot to defend. The flag is grabbed by Moto and tossed towards that respawn. But a nice hold by Bio. Able to keep that flag in front door. And this is probably my favorite spot to play as a soldier. I love playing that front door. You're able to do so much. Even in TFC, it's such a fun position to play, as everything's just coming straight at you, and you have clear rockets to hit. The flag has been tossed forward by Cherry. Now it's at front door. This is a good spot for the offense. But to make it easier, they should get security, and they have an extra way into this base. Moto gets their first capture in about 3 minutes and 20 seconds. That is quite slow, but it's all about breaking the seal of the defense, and that could have done it. Security has gone down. The Demo and Soldier are down. Sentry gun staying up. Actually, it has fallen to team damage. And this could be a time for the offense right now. But a little bit of team damage by Gooster. At possibly the worst time, that was a free flag to get at least out.
Red security offline!
Now, we have seen Blunt Force switch over to 2 Scout, 2 Medic. Moya filling in for that second Scout. Overall, the kills for the offense are very low. Just around 10 kills. While the defense, Bio, with 22 kills, Heavy with 13. It's kind of what I was talking about before in the Saints' first big match, where it's really the Soldier or Heavy to get a lot of kills, and it doesn't really depend on where the offense goes, it's just whoever cleans up. Moto has gotten the second capture within a minute and a half, so that's good for them. They can get this flag moving more and more. But Bio's the main factor of this team right now, definitely getting the major kills. And this is actually surprising to me. Gooster only has 5 kills. He's someone that you don't really think about too much in this game. He was amazing in TFC. But in this game, he's still got a bit to learn, especially on the Heavy front. But he's one that gets so many kills on offense, especially in these matches and scrims that I've seen. It's not like him to see 6 kills, but Moto has grabbed the flag once again. And it will be their third capture, just under 9 minutes to go. This is actually a pretty good pace for them. Like I said, they just need to break the seal, and it looks like they've done that as Cherry grabs the flag, tosses it almost out, but it's in a great position for the offense, and once again, Moto grabs the flag, brings it down into the pit area where it's not the greatest, but we'll see what happens as Moto somehow grabs the flag through that spam, gets the flag out, and that's their fourth capture. Blunt Force Trauma exploiting that Claremont's not set up at all. And Bostwix and Bio are able to clean up the rest of the offense that are here. Bostwix rotating as that Heavy. It's not a bad idea to do that, but if your Soldier's still alive, there's no reason to. I mean, even if you're stuck inside while security's up, you can go up there, but since you're so slow, they're gonna get through that door before you can get back. That's the biggest issue with Heavy. I think it's more about positioning than it is about actual aiming in this game. Because if you're just out of position, you really can't do anything. The Heavy doesn't have any real knockback other than his overpressure. So you need to be very mindful of where you're standing and what you're actually doing. But the flag has been moving here for Blunt, and this is great for them. The constant movement is actually very good, as the flag has been tossed out. This demo is dead, and now if Moya can get in here fast enough, he could get this flag, but the demo has come back, is able to pipe that flag, and once again, the flag is in the spot where it's right against the door. Security's up, and what a rock, but Bio. Holding on to this flag as long as he can, once again with a nice shotgun. Alex, known for his dispensers, he really uses those dispensers offensively. Puts them in places where he knows offense will conk by, and he will debt that whenever he can. He was slightly late on that debt, 9 gets a double. But that's most likely due to not a lot of cells in that dispenser. Actually, the scout gets conked back. That was the flag front door. A nice little drop conk by Moya gets the flag out. And this will be the fifth capture once he re-grabs this in the yard. But Blunt really putting up this fight.
They captured the flag. Red Security online.
And still looking at the defense, we have Bio with 36, Boswix with 29. It's really the demo that's falling behind on kills. And that's this demo, or this game is so fast, you really need to rely on your demo for a lot of maps, especially this one. And I think 9 just needs to step it up quite a little bit. And for the offense, we have just around 30 kills. It's not too bad. It's very familiar comparing the last round and the match before this one. Well, you normally see more around like 70 kills total. Or, yeah, around 60 to 70 kills total. It's strange to see the kills quite a bit lower. But I think that has to do with these stronger defenses. It's harder for the offense to kill. Emoto able to get this flag out, bringing them to 6 captures with under 5 minutes to go. And it is all possible for them to catch up to Claremont. The flag has been grabbed by Cherry and tossed forward. Scout re-grabs and tosses it almost out. The flag gets stuck behind the door, and unfortunate, as they could have gotten that out, and that would have been most likely another capture very shortly. But a nice defense by Bio and 9, holding onto that button. Now the scout is in. The flag actually suspended in air because of that door. And as you see, actually, Alex defending that battlements with a dispenser. Very strange to see. Not a common tactic at all, but a nice conk by Moya. Actually grabs the flag, gets it out, and a nice movement by Blunt moves that flag into a great position for them to attack. Nice follow-up by Moto after the demo goes down, and now the flag is front door. Time is running out for this team, and they need 4 captures to tie, and Blunt's doing a amazing job getting themselves back into this game. It looked very grim at the start. Moto with another grab, able to get that flag. It will be their 7th capture. They're definitely still in this. But it's going to be a tough last 2 minutes. And the sentry gun is really tearing everything up. Bio going front door once again with amazing rockets. The sentry gun is actually right on the button. A very controversial spot, but it is fairly easy to take down if you just stay out of line of sight. But that completely leaves the flag open, and now the flag is out of the flag room. The demo does go down to a team nade. Flag thrown forward. And now it's brought down to front door left at the bottom of the respawn ramp. And this is a great spot for Blunt Force. Moto with a grab brings it slightly forward. Actually jumps off of the engineer's head. The demo goes down, and here comes everyone for the offense. Scout actually misses the flag. Moya with the follow-up. Flag is actually brought back. And Alex with this dispenser front door doing all he can. but a nice follow-up by Alex. A railgun into an imp, getting two kills with just under 30 seconds to go in this map, and hopefully Blunt Force can get this last capture, because they've showed that they deserve it against this team. Just 10 seconds left. Moto gets the flag, unable to get it, but a great job to both teams. Blunt Force really showing they can keep up against one of these better silver teams, and it was a great match to watch.